Precise measurements gathered from GPS stations over time have helped us better understand earthquake hazards. For example, prior to March 11, 2011, scientists noted that hundreds of GPS receivers in northern Honshu had been recording steady westward movement of the stations along the coast. Because the shallow portions of the subducting and overriding plates are locked by friction, the leading edge of the overriding plate was being forced west, uplifting slightly as it was compressed, therefore storing elastic energy. Elastic rebound during the earthquake caused stations along the coast in Miyagi Prefecture to jump east by as much as 14.5 feet, or 4.42 meters. The abrupt uplift of the eastern edge of the overriding plate near the Japan Trench produced the catastrophic tsunami. We now know that a mirror image great earthquake and tsunami happened on the Cascadia subduction zone on January 26, 1700. Evidence for the earthquake of 1700 comes from Native American oral histories, dating of ghost forests on the Pacific Northwest coast, and arrival of a well-documented orphan tsunami that arrived in Japan 9 hours after the earthquake. Over the past decade, the compression of the Cascadia continental margin has been confirmed by GPS data collected by Earthscope's Plate Boundary Observatory. The coastline, near the Juan de Fuca North America plate boundary, is moving northeast more rapidly than the inland areas, while GPS stations east of the Cascade Mountains are not moving. Now let's zoom in to the GPS station at Cape Mears Lighthouse on the Oregon coast and see how it's moving. The graph shows the position of this GPS station each year compared to its starting location in 2000. The sequence of data points documents the northeast motion of Cape Mears at 0.4 inches, or 10.5 millimeters, per year. From 2000 to 2013, Cape Mears has moved northeast about 5.1 inches, or about 130 millimeters. Since the Cascadia earthquake in 1700, Cape Mears has moved by almost 11 feet, or 3.3 meters. What does this imply about the leading edge of the Cascadia continental margin? Let's look again at a cross-section with graphs reflecting the movement of each GPS station. We'll use a spring to represent the elastic nature of the overriding plate. Coastal stations are pushed northeast by the Juan de Fuca plate at a faster rate than inland areas, so elastic energy builds within the leading edge of the overriding plate. Just as the westward motion of GPS stations in Japan recorded growing stress on that subduction zone prior to the 2011 earthquake, the steady movement of GPS stations in coastal Cascadia also indicates growing stress. Although friction between the Juan de Fuca and North American plates has prevented our spring from releasing, when that friction is ultimately overcome, the resulting earthquake will cause Cape Mears to jump southwest, back near the position after the Great Cascadia Earthquake of 1700. Here's what that elastic rebound process would look like in map view. Although we can't predict when or where the next earthquake will happen along the subduction zone, we are certain that one will eventually occur. Understanding the meaning of these GPS observations should motivate us to build an earthquake and tsunami resilient Pacific Northwest.